Okay, in this video today, we're going to go over the new dimensions and measurements inside Plasticity 1.4. I am currently using 1.4.3. That is the most current stable version. So definitely go download it if you're still on 1.3. These dimensions and measurements are a highly requested feature and are now live. And they do work great. There are some limitations to them. Obviously, you cannot select them within the viewport, but you can select them over here in your panel and just select it. But you can only toggle visibility, you know, turn it on and off, or you can group it into a group or whatever. They act just like they're organized just like sheets, solids, and now there's measurements. So let me show you how to go about working with them here. So as you can see here, I've got my little habitat that I've been working on. So I figured I'd use this as an example. So say like I want to measure my radar dish up here. So I'm just going to isolate them by hitting period. And don't mind my voice, just getting over a cold. So I'm going to line them up to the axis here. And if we want to do a measurement that has a call out, you do control and equal. And then all we have to do is select two points. So I want to select this outer mid here. And then this outer mid here, and that'll get me my width of my dish. And depending on where you're aligned on orbit around the object, that's where it's going to draw it. So let me get back to the front here. There we go. And now it aligns straight up. And all I have to do is just pull it until we're happy with the distance and then left click. And there you go. It now has the 1.824 meters. I don't think I have my habitat scaled quite correctly, but it's pretty close. But that's how big it is. Like I said, you cannot select them, but it will update. So let's take a look here. If I select the dish, and then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here, and then I'm going to do scale V, and I want to be, I want to be back here. There we go. Get to the center of the dish. Without the hinges there. Now zoom out here so you can see the dimensions. And as you can see, it will auto update to whatever it is. Now the only thing is you can't click on that and say, hey, I want it to be 2 meters. No, it doesn't work that way. So there's still some improvements, but I mean, it's pretty awesome so far. The thing to remember with dimensions, or in this case, measurement. It's attached to this midpoint on this line right here. So, I mean, I can move that out and it'll auto update. Click. See, it auto updated. So, but if I make that particular point just disappear. Okay, so I selected my faces there of my extrude, and then if I just hit X to delete it, the dimensions go away because it lost that one point of reference. So that's just something you gotta be aware of when you're manipulating, or when you want to make sure you keep your measurements and stuff like that. So as long as you don't delete that anchor point, it'll be okay. So let's come out of isolate here. You can do other things like with the measurement here. Say like I just want to measure just this particular line. You know, say like I want to figure out the, you know, just what that line is, which would be at the end of that radius down to this part down here. So if I just do control plus or control equal, and then just select the line, but don't grab a midpoint. Just select it somewhere in between and just grab the edge. Wait, There we go. Got to go in the right direction. Boom. And as you can see, it just measured the line for me. Okay? So, that's basically measurements in a nutshell. And like I said, you can connect it to any anchor point wherever. So, let's see. Let me show you like a weird example here. So, say like... I'll do it from the center of here all the way down to just this arbitrary point. Do it to the mid here, okay? Okay, got that drawn out. Okay, now you can see that it's got this weird 3D pathfinding call out here. So it's basically is because we're working in 3D space that it'll create this kind of abstract call out here, but it still works the same way as some of these other straight across or what have you. So just something to remember whenever you're doing kind of odd angles that aren't, you know, coplanar or directly aligned with each other. So let's play with dimensions now. Okay, it falls under the same category as measurement, but you can do some kind of cool things here. And this works with your basic primitives and coplanar flat surfaces, as well as your circular radius, or not diameter, not radius. So, all right, so if I just select a face, this circular face here, and I hit just equal, don't hit control, because that's measurement, you can see that this diameter of this face here is 3 meters. Well, what if I want it to be 2.5? There, it adjusts it to 2.5. Okay, well, I got this guy over here. He's not 2.5. So what if I select him and then hit equal? You can see he's 1.5, but I got both of them selected. So why don't we just make them both 3? That's kind of cool. So I can match sizes and stuff like that. But even let me scale him back to whatever here. So now I have him selected, and then I select him. Let's see. If I do equals, you can see it's 3 meters. And then if I hit enter, so whatever the last face selection or cylinder or coplanar face I select, it'll match both of them. So say like select this. If I'm doing like a flat planar, it's going to look at the other flat planar across from it. So if I do equal, all right, it's 2.223. I can make him, let's just go 5. See, so there's a lot of cool things that you can do. So let's take a look at our square box over here, or a rectangle. And let's do something like, okay, hit equal. All right, 3.924. Why don't we just make him 4? Okay, cool. So, and it's just analyzing the other coplanar face across from it. So just hit equal, 4. Now I got a perfectly square box. And even more so, I could do 4, perfect square. So now he's 4 all the way around. So let's show you how to interact. Let's punch a hole in here. I'm going to do it off axis, not dead center. Okay, so same deal. Okay, so how wide is that? Or what's the diameter? 0.653. Well, let's just make him 1. Cool. Well, what if I want to line him up in the center of this cube, a 4x4 cube? Well, I just select this face here, hit equal, and then, so what's half of 4? 2. Oops. You want to do it the other way. You want to select this face first, and then him. Basically, the last thing selected is what's going to move. So I want to do equals. 2. Okay, so he's centered this way. So let's do this selection plus 2. And there you go. Now he is absolutely dead center there. So I can even do some callouts here. So we do control plus. There you go. You know it's exactly 2 meters to the center there. So, well, I need to do a call out for that radius. So if I just select him, oops, yeah, just do control plus, escape that, control plus, and then just select a non-point. There we go. And there we go. And I can even, if I need to adjust that, I can do plus 2.5. Boom. It updated it for us. As you can see. So that is basically the new measurements and dimensions inside Plasticity 1.4. Great little feature to make out technical drawings or to help you get things measured just right, especially for 3D printing. So that's it. Have fun with it, and we'll catch you in the next video.